On Friday, the European Union announced its plans that as of next year, its member states would no longer have daylight savings time. And when this was discussed online and in the media, people kept bringing up the point that daylight savings kills people. And I was like, well, hang on, is that true? Is it true that daylight savings kills people? We're doing that every time, aren't we? That's fine. Okay, so I looked into it. I checked the statistics and some of the research, and it turns out the answer is yes, but no. It is true, of course, that daylight savings changes have an impact on your life. I, for one, love it when the clocks fall back because I get a bonus hour of existence, which I squander on sleeping in. Of course, I had to borrow that. When the clocks spring forward, you lose an hour of your life, or rather, you lend it and you get it back later on. And this can impact your life. You can accidentally show up for work an hour early and be embarrassed, or an hour late and be fired. It can be more serious than that, though, with an actual medical link. It seemed as though changes in people's sleep cycle could have an impact on their cardiovascular system. It could give them a heart attack. And so the fine people at the University of Michigan got their top cardiovascular crack team on it, and they took all the statistics from the Blue Cross Blue Shield Cardiovascular Consortium database, which, just saying that, can give you a heart attack. They looked at all the times the clocks changed between March 2010 and September 2013 to see if people having to change their sleep cycle because of daylight savings time was causing them to have more heart attacks. For a start, they were able to prove there definitely is a link between sleeping and heart attack rates. Monday is the worst day for heart attacks, partly because of stress going back to work and all that, but also because of changes to sleep cycle. But they were able to control for that, remove all the seasonal variations, which also show up in heart attack data, and just look at the changes because of the clocks changing. And sure enough, there was an impact on the Monday after the clocks spring forward and people lose an hour of sleep. Heart attack rates went up by 24% on that Monday. And when the clocks went back later on and people got an extra hour of sleep, heart attacks went down by 21%. So the clocks changing is killing people 24% more on that day after. Except that's really not the whole story. The 24% increase in heart attacks when clocks spring forward and the 21% decrease when they fall back was only on that one day. If you average across a whole week instead of just over a day, the effect disappears completely. More people are dying, but only dying earlier. It just accelerated people who would have had a heart attack anyway. The clock springing forward, removing sleep, means that people who were going to have a heart attack later in the week had it earlier. Across the whole week, no change. And likewise, the clock's falling back, and so you get your bonus hour of sleep, merely delayed heart attacks. People were bought a few more days before their heart turned on them, but across the whole week, no change. So I get so annoyed whenever I see people bring out the statistic going, oh, changing the clocks kills people. I'm like, no, it does, but that's not looking at the stats correctly. I mean, that's useful to know if you're planning staffing levels in a hospital, because you need to know when the heart attacks are going to happen. So you have to factor in daylight savings time. But to claim that daylight savings kills people, that's going to give me a heart attack, is not true. It's a disingenuous use of statistics, and I get very upset. Fun fact, just because the EU says you can't have daylight savings doesn't mean you can't benefit from a bonus hour of sleep. I, for one, take an hour off Friday nights. Who misses Friday night, 10 p.m. to 11 p.m.? It's a blur anyway, and I put that when I need it on Monday morning. I call it clock piling. Save that hour for when you really need it. I mean, maybe one day I'll just take quarter of an hour off every single day. I'll save up, give myself an extra Tuesday. Thanks for watching the video. The University of Michigan have actually made their research fully available. It's open access publishing, openheart.bmj. It's pretty funny. You can actually go to their website, download the paper, check it all for yourself, look at the statistics, see if you agree with my interpretation. And I've actually written about this heart attack stat in my new book, Humble Pie. a comedy of maths errors. It's all about maths mistakes. I didn't just want to look at, you know, people have made adding up or magic square mistakes. I wanted to look at the kind of logic behind mathematics. And this is a great example because, I mean, technically the stat is correct, but the interpretation is wrong because people are averaging over the wrong time period. And that subtle misuse of mathematics and statistics, the logic, that's what I find interesting. And there are loads of stories in the book, everything from engineering, programming, medicine, you name it. Hopefully it's in there. It's actually not out though until March 2019. You can pre-order it now. It's on Amazon, the UK store at least, and it's on my website, Maths Gear. And actually, I'd really appreciate it if you can pre-order it. That does genuinely help because of the way publishing stats work. So if you order it on Maths Gear, we'll be selling it properly once it's out. But if you pre-order, you will get it the moment. Like as soon as it lands in the Maths Gear office, I will sign it and boom, it's out to you.